गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. इन प्रीवियस वीडियो वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द डीएनए, इट्स केमिकल कंपोजिशन एंड द टाइप्स ऑफ न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स एंड न्यूक्लियोसाइड्स वी डिस्कस्ड. ओके, सो नाउ इन दिस वीडियो लेट अस वी डिस्कस अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ डीएनए. स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ डीएनए. So before going to study the Watson and Crick model, let us be see the details about the structure, that is DNA. Actually, that as you know, DNA is a long polymer of deoxy ribonucleotides. Understood? It's nothing but it's a long polymer of what it is made up of deoxyribonucleotides. Deoxyribonucleotides. Understood? So it's a long chain. How do you measure long chain means? Okay, let us we see later. I hope you understood deoxyribonucleotides. So usually, how many types of nucleotides are present in a DNA? There should be a 4. Even in RNA also 4. Okay. So based on the nitrogen bases, there are 4 nitrogen bases as you know: adenine, guanine, cytosine, and thymine. These are the 4 nitrogen bases which are present in the DNA. Based on this, there are 4 types of nucleotides. What you call deoxyribonucleotides are formed. Deoxyribonucleotides. Understood? So there are many deoxyribonucleotides of 4 types which are joined, which are linked, which are binded, what we call. So by as you know, phosphodiester bond and makes a chain, a long chain, that is called polymer. Okay, that's what we call, that is simply we can say it as a polynucleotide chain. So this is what the DNA, what you call DNA, okay, polynucleotide chain. So forms a DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid we call, no? Okay, and then the what is the length? See, length of DNA, how do you define the length? How can you define it? See, the length, it is defined as number of nucleotides. Number of nucleotides means here deoxyribonucleotides, number of nucleotides present in it. See, that means very important, number of nucleotides, that is the deoxyribonucleotides present in that DNA is the length of that DNA. Understood? See, nucleotides also called base pairs, hence we also refer it as BP, base pairs. Okay, usually, for example, you can take the example for the length of DNA, bacteriophage. You can take bacteriophage. So there is a specific bacteriophage, there are different types are there. So that is you can take the example. Phi X 174. Okay, so it is referred as phi. Even phi X you can mention. Okay, phi X 174. So this bacteriophage has 5386. What do you call? 5386 BP means nucleotides. Okay, so 5386 base pairs are present in a bacteriophage, that is 5174. It is also mentioned 5X174. There are different numbers are given as a scientific name for these bacteriophages. One more bacteriophage can take, bacteriophage lambda. Bacteriophage, that is lambda. So you can take bacteriophage lambda. Bacteriophage lambda. Okay, so this has the nitrogen bases of 48,502 BP base pairs. That means about in this case, this is the bacteriophage. 5386 base pairs are present, and here in this bacteriophage lambda, 48,502 base pairs are present. Okay, so this is what the length it is measured. Okay, so that is the length of this bacteriophage, length of DNA DNA bacteriophage, and one more bacteriophage are given, and both these two are viruses. These are the examples for virus. One more I will take, the bacteria. So here usually in this bacteria, in this case instead of double stranded, single stranded we can say single stranded DNA will be present. Single stranded DNA is present. Okay, so in human beings usually double stranded DNA will be there. Okay, next bacteria E. coli, as you know, is most familiar bacteria, E. coli bacteria. Okay, so it's about 4.6 into 10 raised to 6 BP. This much of number of base pairs are present. Okay, so next one more example we can take, human beings, human. Okay, so that man, in this haploid set, when you observe haploid, will you understand haploid? Haploid means single set of chromosomes, that is half of the DNA, total DNA. So it's about 3.3 into 10 raised to 9 BP. So this is the length of DNA. Okay, so number of you can see the definition, it is defined as number of nucleotides present in it. This defines the length of DNA. Okay, so how actually, so that is the distance between the what we called the two nitrogen bases. Then later on in angstrom units when we are studying that structure, we will understand that. Okay, these are the examples, so you remember. Okay, so next let us we see the how the base rule is there and Chargaff's rule is there. Okay, now base pair rule. See, when you observe the structure of DNA, there are some common observations are there. See, purines always pairs with pyrimidines. Purines always pairs with pyrimidines. That means purine is not combined with purine, which is not pairing with purine. So pairing means what here? So actually, the DNA is commonly observed as double stranded DNA. What do you call DS DNA. Understood? DS DNA. Double stranded means what? The single polynucleotide chain. So this is the single polynucleotide chain. Okay. So as you know, the backbone of the this chain is PS, like you can take. Okay. And for this sugar, okay, so this is the what you call, you can mention it as like this. Okay. For this sugar or every sugar, there is a, yes, what is there? Either purine or pyrimidine. Understood? For example, I will take here A. Here you can write Z, T. Okay, next one more I will take. Yes, P, yes, P. Okay, in this way, it's a elongated chain is there, and next for this next C you can take. Okay, so these are the nitrogen bases which are attached to the yes first carbon of sugar. Okay, next this is one chain, polynucleotide chain. Okay, so this chain is when it's double stranded means one more chain will be present here. For this side, one more chain is present. Okay, so you can take it as here. Yes, 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 yeah, yes. So for this one more polynucleotide chain here, adenine is one of the purine. Next there should be a pyrimidine. Pyrimidine means which pyrimidine? So again in this rule, specific purine, what you call specific purine always pairs with specific pyrimidine. Very important. Specific purine means here, for example, adenine is a purine, another one guanine is a purine. Okay, adenine and guanine are purines, and pyrimidines are, yes, there are two pyrimidines. What are those? Three are there, but in DNA two are there. So that is thymine and cytosine. Okay, adenine always combines with pairs with thymine, and guanine always combines with yes cytosine. So and also you remember by double bond. Okay, adenine combines with thymine by the help of double bond. These are the hydrogen bonds, what we call. And guanine is a purine, which combines with pyrimidine. So this is one of the pyrimidine, that is cytosine. Understood? So this is the guanine and cytosine always combines with the help of triple bond, that is what we call. These are the what we referred, hydrogen bonds. Hydrogen bond. This linkage is called hydrogen bond. Okay. So you remember this one, very important. That is the base rule we called. Base means these are the base pairs, nitrogen base pairs. They are combining in particular way, that is adenine always bonds with thymine, okay, with a double bond. And guanine is a purine, is combines with a pyrimidine, that is cytosine. Okay, so this is the pattern. In this way, according to this, there are double stranded DNA means so that should be adenine is combines with yes what is that, thymine, and guanine is combines with yes cytosine. Next here thymine is there, means here adenine will come. Okay, here already cytosine is there, so in this side, so which one will come? That is yes guanine. Okay, in this way the arrangement is there. Okay, hence we call it as a it's a polypeptide chain which are anti-parallel to each other, what we call anti-parallel complementary strand, we can say, which are referred as complementary strands. Okay, complementary, why we called? Because the specific purine is always pairs with the specific pyrimidine, that is adenine pairs with thymine and guanine pairs with cytosine. Okay.